हेलो पीपल, इन दिस वीडियो लेट अस लुक एट पायरीफॉर्म साइनस और पायरीफॉर्म फोसा. ओके, दे कैन ईदर कॉल इट एज पायरीफॉर्म साइनस और पायरीफॉर्म फोसा. इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज स्मगलर्स फोसा. दिस इज अ पार्ट ऑफ योर हाइपोफेरिंग्स विच इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज लैरिंगो फेरिंग्स, राइट? सो हियर यू कैन सी द पायरीफॉर्म फोसा, नॉर्मल पायरीफॉर्म फोसा राइट एंड लेफ्ट, राइट? दे आर सेइंग हियर दैट व्हेन द पेशेंट फोनेट्स यू कैन सी इट बेटर. सो वेयर इज योर, this is your vocal fold, right? And here inside your trachea will be there. Your air goes inside like this. So this is a part of your larynx, right? So here you have the pyriform fossa. Here, why they are asking you this in the exam? Because guys, some foreign body can get stuck there, okay? And some people keep things there to smuggle and all that. So some historical importance. Also, there can be carcinoma of this pyriform sinus, etc. So where can you see the pyriform fossa here? See pyriform fossa here, pyriform fossa. So where, from where to where do you think it is? We have to read all that. There are some hidden areas in the larynx. They include some things like infrahyoid, epiglottis, anterior commissure, subglottis, ventricle, and the apex of pyriform fossa. Apex of pyriform fossa, they are saying you cannot see hidden area of larynx. So basically, we are talking about what? Laryngopharynx or the hypopharynx. That is the lower part of your pharynx. So your hypopharynx or laryngopharynx will be from where? From your hyoid bone till the lower end of cricoid. Okay. So that will be the laryngopharynx from here to here. So from the lower end of your hyoid bone, from the hyoid bone to the lower end of cricoid. Okay. So where is your voice box here? So around this, you will have the pyriform fossa. So guys, the hypopharynx will lie opposite to the 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th cervical vertebrae. Clinically, it is divided into three regions. Which are the three regions? It's divided into the pyriform sinus, the post-cricoid region, and the posterior pharyngeal wall. Three things. So we are looking only at the pyriform sinus here. What are the other things? Post-cricoid region and the posterior pharyngeal wall. Posterior pharyngeal wall, post cricoid, and then pyriform sinus. We are looking only at the pyriform sinus in this video. So how many pyriform sinuses do you have? Two. It lies either side of the larynx and extends from where? Pharyngoepiglottic fold to the upper end of esophagus. From where to where is it, guys? From the pharyngoepiglottic fold to the upper end of esophagus. It is laterally bound by thyrohyoid membrane. So which will be lateral here? You're seeing from the behind. So anyways, laterally it's bounded by what? The thyrohyoid membrane, the membrane between the thyroid cartilage and the hyoid bone, thyrohyoid membrane and the thyroid cartilage itself. Medially you have what? Medially, very clearly you're able to see, guys. Medially what is there? Medially by the array epiglottic fold. So here also you have array epiglottic fold, and laterally you have the thyrohyoid membrane and the thyroid cartilage. Okay. It forms the lateral channel for food, they are saying. What is it? So because your esophagus is here, how can it form a lateral channel for your food? Okay, but anyways, here actually things get stuck, right? Foreign body gets stuck here. There can be tumors here. That's why it's important. And smugglers can use it. See, very important thing here is internal laryngeal nerve runs submucously in the lateral wall of the sinus. In the lateral wall of the sinus, you have the internal laryngeal nerve. So it is very easy to access it for the local anesthesia. That is another importance of your pyriform sinus or fossa. Okay. So what is the importance? The internal laryngeal nerve runs submucosally in the lateral wall of the sinus. Okay. Referred pain to ear. So if there's any problem with your pyriform fossa, you can have ear pain. So this is referred otalgia. So you have seen this, remember? In the carcinoma of pyriform sinus, actually, see here. In the carcinoma of pyriform sinus, via the vagus nerve, you can have referred otalgia. Okay. So this is in the carcinoma of pyriform sinus itself. So let's put this here. Referred pain to ear will be where? In carcinoma itself. Let's put this here. Okay. There can be foreign body here. Then smugglers, we told you. Smugglers fossa it is called as. Okay. There can be cystic lesions associated with the pyriform fossa. Carcinoma can be there. And we have studied this branchial cleft sinus. Remember the third one. For the third one, the internal opening is actually in the pyriform sinus. Wait, we'll show. You remember this branchial cyst, the lateral neck swelling. In that, we have seen the types, right? See, this is the third one. The third branchial cleft cyst and sinus tract, inside internal opening is actually in the pyriform fossa. Very important. That is the importance of piriform sinus. One more importance. So you have so many that the second one we are not talking about. We are talking about the third one. In the third one, the internal opening is at the piriform sinus. Okay. So now you got the importance why we are looking at piriform sinus, right? Why they ask it in the exam, everything you understood. Okay. So the other two things of hypopharynx, we are not looking at postcricoid region and posterior pharyngeal wall. We are not looking at these. Guys, this piriform sinus has rich supply of lymphatics, okay. They exit through the thyrohyoid membrane and drain into the upper jugular chain. So, you should know this. You should know the lymphatic drainage, right? Why should you know that lymphatic drainage, guys? Because high lymphatic network of piriform fossae explain the high frequency with which nodal metastases are seen in the carcinoma of this region. So, whenever there is carcinoma of this region, you will see high frequency with nodal metastasis. Okay. Pre-laryngeal node, that is the Delphian node, okay, drains this region. This lies where on the cricothyroid membrane. It drains the subglottic region of the larynx and also piriform sinus, Delphian node. Okay. Guys, based on the importance, let's look at a few things like foreign body we'll look at. Okay, then we'll look at some cystic lesion. Then we will look at some carcinoma. Okay, let's look at all this. So let's look at these. So the ingested foreign body can go where? It can go to piriform fossa, like fish bone, chicken, mutton bone, needle, dentures can go there. Okay, you can remove small foreign bodies under local anesthesia with a curved forceps. Large ones you'll have to remove under general anesthesia with endoscopy. Even those in children, you have to remove under general anesthesia. Pooling of secretions in piriform fossa, you can see in indirect laryngoscopy. Okay. So, these won't disappear on swallowing. See, when you do indirect laryngoscopy, what structures you will see, right? You will see the larynx, you will see the laryngopharynx, oropharynx. Here in the laryngopharynx, yeah, they have mentioned, you can see piriform fossae. Okay. So, let's check out this one now, cystic lesion. So, where is cystic lesion? Cystic lesion, there are of three types in that you have. Cystic lesion of what? Of larynx. So, here you have three types of lesions. You have ductal, saccular and laryngocele. In the ductal one, you can have in piriform fossa. Okay. Ductal cyst, you can see in piriform fossa. Okay. You can see what? A ductal cyst in a piriform fossa. Ductal cyst, you can see in piriform fossa. Let's add that here. You can see a ductal cyst in a piriform fossa. Then let's move to carcinoma, guys. So, in tumors of the hypopharynx, you have the malignant tumor. You have a very common, it seems this is. How sad, right? So, no wonder they are asking you to read more about this piriform fossa. And most tumors are of squamous cell type. And the sites involved, the first thing they mentioned is piriform sinus. Piriform sinus. Squamous cell type, malignant tumor, carcinoma of your hypopharynx, very common piriform fossa. Okay. Otherwise, what are the other regions? All the other areas of a hypopharynx, post-cricoid, posterior pharyngeal wall, same thing. But in the hypopharynx, most affected is what? Piriform sinus. Okay, then. Usually, this will be in men, guys, the carcinoma of piriform sinus. It can be exophytic or ulcerative and deeply infiltrative. Okay. So, basically what will happen, this is enough space for it to grow, right? So, it can be asymptomatic for a long time. You can check nodes, okay, neck nodes, metastatic neck nodes will be the first thing that to catch your attention. Not this, this wouldn't have caused any problem, but you will see some metastatic neck nodes may be the first to attract your attention, okay? Spread of this tumor. It will spread upwards to the valicula and the base of tongue. So, it's coming up, valicula, base of tongue, guys. And it can go down, post-cricoid region. It's going everywhere then. Medially, it can go to array epiglottic folds. Look at this. So, from your piriform sinus, it can go up to your valicula, then to your base of tongue. Then it can go to post-cricoid area. Then it can go medially to your array epiglottic fold. Then actually, they are saying downwards to post-cricoid, okay, downwards to post-cricoid and medially to array epiglottic folds, इट मे इन्फिल्ट्रेट इन टू थायरॉइड कार्टिलेज. थायरॉइड ग्लैंड मे प्रेजेंट अ सॉफ्ट टिश्यू मास इन द नेक. सो इट कैन प्रेजेंट अ सॉफ्ट टिश्यू मास इन द नेक. हियर दे आर सेइंग द स्प्रेड इज हाउ लिम्फैटिक स्प्रेड अकर्स अर्ली. रिमेंबर दिस, द लिम्फैटिक स्प्रेड अकर्स अर्ली बिकॉज इट हैज अ रिच लिम्फैटिक नेटवर्क. गाइस फोकस हियर, वी टॉक्ड अबाउट व्हाट डेल्फियन नोड. Distant metastasis can occur late. Okay, it can even affect your lung, liver, and bones. So obviously, late only this will occur, right? Okay. So this is the spread; it will go everywhere around. Then coming to clinical features of what? Carcinoma of your piriform sinus. Carcinoma piriform sinus. We are looking at clinical features, guys. So they told it can be asymptomatic because there is a space for it to grow. So earliest thing you can pick up is a metastatic node, neck node, right? You can see a neck mass also, something sticking in the throat or pricking sensation on swallowing, maybe the earliest symptom. We already told you via the vagus nerve there can be referred otalgia, pain, right? Pain on swallowing and increasing dysphagia. Mass of lymph nodes high up in the neck may be the first sign. We already told you this. Then hoarseness, always anything to do with larynx, just blame hoarseness of voice, right? Laryngeal obstruction may indicate laryngeal edema. So whenever there's laryngeal edema, what do they say you should do? Tracheostomy. It could be one of the indications. Now let us come to the diagnosis. How will you know this person has a carcinoma of the piriform sinus? How will you diagnose? So you can do some examination. Minor examination itself will give all the information looks like. And pooling of secretions will obstruct the view. Barium swallow CT scan you can do. I think this barium swallow, they said, is kind of, they don't do much nowadays. CT scan, let's say CT scan is, okay. Then, endoscopic examination is necessary for biopsy. So, you can take biopsy to know that it is carcinoma, right? Biopsy, okay. How will you take biopsy? Endoscopic examination is necessary for biopsy and accurate assessment and find out, etc., etc. So, basically, this is how you are going to diagnose. Now, coming to treatment, what will you do? Radiotherapy. Early means you can do radiotherapy. Early growth can be cured by without nodes. It didn't come to nodes. That means this will be almost in a pre-symptomatic stage kind of a thing or asymptomatic. Radiotherapy you can do. Okay. You can do total laryngectomy or partial pharyngectomy. Pharyngectomy, laryngectomy. Pharyngectomy partial. Laryngectomy total you can do. Okay, remaining pharynx can be primarily closed. Look at this, pharyngoesophageal segment is reconstructed with mucocutaneous flaps or stomach pull-up. So they are reconstructing something. And with patients who have no palpable nodes, no neck. What is this? N0 neck, N0. There's a staging, right? You can give them radiotherapy. That's what they said, right? There's something here called as block dissection, guys. Along with block dissection. Basically here, they are removing the lymph nodes or something. Okay. So basically, if it is not involving lymph node, then why you want to do block dissection, right? Don't do block dissection. Just give radiotherapy. That's it. That's all they are telling. Okay. So did you understand piriform sinus? That's why the lymphatic drainage and all is very important. So in supraglottic cancer, that is above your glottis, the supraglottic cancer also can spread to piriform fossa. So piriform fossa can get cancer from supraglottic area also. Remember that. Okay. So we already told about branchial cysto fistula, the third branchial cleft sinus. Guys, let's take a recap. In this video, we wanted to look at piriform sinus or piriform fossa. Basically, it's also called a smuggler's fossa. It is there in the hypopharynx or laryngopharynx. So here you can see the piriform fossa marked here. This is your piriform fossa. So this is the hidden area of larynx. The apex of the piriform fossa is hidden. So hypopharynx, you know where it is. It's the lowest part of the pharynx. It has three parts, the piriform sinus, the post-cricoid region and the posterior pharyngeal wall. Here look, we are looking at what? Piriform sinus. It is more prone to the carcinoma amongst all the other three. So the piriform sinus or fossa, what is there? On either side of larynx, it extends from the pharyngoepiglottic fold to the upper end of esophagus. How is it bounded? Laterally by the thyrohyoid membrane, thyroid cartilage, medially by the araepiglottic fold, right? And the internal laryngeal nerve runs submucosally in the lateral wall of the sinus. It is easily accessible for local anesthesia. So, other two parts of hypopharynx. The lymphatic drainage of this Piriform fossa is very important, guys. It is richly supplied by lymphatics. It is drained into the upper jugular chain. This is very important, guys. That is why you can see carcinoma spreading to the neck nodes. So this will show you that the first thing that you will see is the nodal metastasis, because this piriform fossa is quite big enough for things to be sitting and growing. Like here you can see the piriform fossa, right? This is the vocal folds. Here you can see the piriform fossa. So big enough for things to sit here and grow, even foreign body or a tumor. So it will be asymptomatic. The first thing you could catch is your neck nodes. Okay, that's why they're talking about the lymphatic drainage of this area. So here they're talking about pre-laryngeal nodes, Delphian nodes. Okay. So when you do indirect laryngoscopy, you can see this piriform fossa as they have shown here. So why is this so important? We told you the internal laryngeal nerve runs submucosally in the lateral wall. It is accessible for local anesthesia. Foreign bodies can sit here. Smuggler's fossa, people can keep things and smuggle. Cystic lesions can be here. The ductal cyst can be in this of the larynx, right? Carcinoma can be there, where the pain can go to the ear, and then you will know that the cause can be a tumor of the piriform sinus, a carcinoma, malignancy. Third, branchial cleft sinus, internal opening will be into the piriform sinus. So these are all the importances. Okay. So foreign body, if you take like any fish bone, chicken, mutton bone, needle, denture may lodge here. So you'll have to remove this under local anesthetic using some curved forceps. Okay. So you give local anesthetic and curved forceps. But if it is a large body, then you will have to use general anesthesia and endoscopic removal. Okay. Even in children, you'll have to use general anesthesia for large impacted foreign body. Okay. And even for children, you will use endoscopy. So pooling of secretions in piriform fossa, all this can be because of tumor or these foreign body, and these don't disappear on swallowing the secretions, is it? So you can see this on indirect laryngoscopy. Cystic lesions of larynx, you can see here the non-neoplastic ones, the cystic in the ductal cyst you can have in piriform fossa sinus. Guys, what are we doing? Taking a recap of this piriform sinus, remember, piriform fossa. So tumor of hypopharynx, especially the malignant tumor, happens more in piriform sinus when you consider hypopharynx. Okay, very common it is in India, squamous cell type. So here you will see mostly in males, it can be exophytic or ulcerative and deeply infiltrative. They will remain asymptomatic for a long time because the space is there to grow. Metastatic nodes may be the first attraction. Spread, it will spread upward to the vellicular base of tongue, downward to post-cricoid region, medially to the array epiglottic folds and ventricles. It may also go into the thyroid cartilage, thyroid gland, even the soft tissue mass in neck it can present as. Lymphatic spread will be early. Distant metastasis then later can occur to lung, liver, bones, etc. Early symptoms, usually they will just have some sticking in the throat, pricking sensation on swallowing. Referred otalgia they can have. The lymph nodes high up in the neck may be the first sign. Hoarseness, laryngeal obstruction due to laryngeal edema, etc. They can have referred pain, right? Ear, otalgia, referred otalgia because of the vagus nerve. Very good. Then, how will you diagnose? CT scan, endoscopic biopsy. Treatment, you will just do a partial pharyngectomy, total laryngectomy, radiotherapy if it is very initial. And if you can do block dissection, you can remove all the lymph nodes. They can do some pharyngo esophageal segment reconstruction, and in case there is no palpable nodes, then you can as well do only radiotherapy without this block dissection. Okay, then coming to supraglottic cancer, that can also spread to piriform fossa. That's it, guys. So branchial sinus or fistula, you saw the third branchial cyst cleft cyst and sinus tract. You can see here inside it is opening at the piriform fossa. Okay. So all these are the importance of piriform sinus fossa. Everything we have covered here in this video. Bye bye.